Now there are certain people, those are suffering from Shoki syndrome. I don't believe. So if he has got this attitude, Quran is not of any use, these ayat, these signs are not of any use to them. Now, when they recognize Allah, oh my Lord, this or did all this. Now he has to remember Allah. Allatheena yadhkuruna Allaha qiyaman wa qu'udan wa 'ala junubihim. Those who remember Allah while standing, sitting and lying on his side. Wa yatafakkaruna fi khalqis samawati wal ard. And reflect upon the creation of heavens and the earth, crying out, Rabbana ma khalaqta hadha batila. Our Lord, you did not create this purposeless. Now if you reflect upon this universe, you will come to one conclusion for sure. After the conclusion that Allah, your Lord, has created all this for you, second conclusion would be that all this is not worthless and useless. Allah has not created anything useless. And what is the use? Service of mankind. Sun is my servant. Moon is my servant. Winds are my servant. Rains are my servant. These trees are my servant. Animals are my servant. And even in the animal kingdom, one animal is the food of the other. This is the food of the other. This is the food of another. And finally, who benefits that animal? Now, very good, very big question mark. What man is meant for? Just to come, grow up to a young man, get older, and then die away? Get buried into the earth? No. This is impossible. You know, if we assume this, that means all this is useless. Because the final result is useless, so everything is useless. It's unbelievable. Rabbana ma khalaqta hadha batila. Oh Allah, oh my Lord, you didn't create all this useless. How can I use this? Second. Now, to answer this question, I must look into myself. When I look into myself, I find that there is a criterion of good and bad in my inner sight. By birth I know that I must speak the truth, I should never tell a lie. Is it? It's a call from inside. The whole of this universe is focused at man. But the inner focus of man is morality. Right and wrong. But if I act accordingly, mostly the result is opposite. Whereas the physical laws are, meaning if I act upon the moral laws, the results are not positive. Whereas the physical laws are perfect. For example, fire burns. It's a physical law. Now if there is a hot tea or coffee just removed from fire and by mistake I take a sip of it, what will happen? I will burn my palate, I will burn my tongue, may even lips. Whereas if I tell a lie, do I have it boiled in the pan? No. The physical law is if you take contaminated food, you'll have bad stomach. Whereas if you act upon the moral law, that you take someone else's food, are you going to have a pain in the stomach? No. This brings a question mark. Physical world is perfect, but the moral world is not perfect yet. If Allah Almighty has given me this moral law within, certainly it will have some manifestation. And that manifestation leads me to think there is going to be some life after that. And this is what we find here. رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا سُبْحَانَكَ. Glory to you. You are above this, that you create something useless. So protect us from the punishment of fire. رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ مَنْ دُخِلِ النَّارِ. And this is the same subject which has been discussed in Surah 3:2. You know, had it been a universe of some ruler which is not powerful, we could assume, yes, the culprits do wrong, they do atrocities, and then they run away. Someone doing some atrocity in Uganda may get asylum in UK. But there is any asylum against the kingdom of Allah? No. And if the culprits are not punished, then Allah is not a capable ruler. You know, if there is some atrocity in the town and police is not able to get hold of the culprits, what statement the politicians of the town will give? Government should get hold of the culprits or resign. Because if the government cannot, if the ruler cannot get hold of the culprit and punish them, they are incapable rulers. So in the end of Surah 3, what Allah Almighty says, that there is right and wrong. Yet what makes you deny the day of judgment, the day of reward? Alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is Allah not the best of the rulers? You see. So if Allah Almighty is the creator of this universe, and here the culprits are not punished, and let me tell you, in this life it's not possible to punish the culprits even if you get hold of them. For example, an old man having a gun in his hand comes to the market and just fires and kills 20 people. How can you punish him? Can you punish him? Can you? No, you cannot punish him. Even if you get hold of him, number one, if he runs away, maybe police cannot get hold of him. Even if the police is able to get hold of him, maybe police cannot prosecute him properly and bring him to the court. And the court declares him not guilty. Let us suppose police is able to do that and the judge declares him guilty too. What punishment can he give him? Death penalty? I don't believe this is the punishment. Is it? He is an old man. He killed 20 young people, having dozens of children, tens of wives. His atrocity is much more than one death penalty. There should be a life of such a nature that he can be killed 20 times. And he faces the punishment of all the atrocity and damage done to their families. Children. You know, dozens of children are orphaned. And tens of women were widows. So, for the sufficient punishment, there has to be continuation of this life of a different nature. And that is what the hereafter is.
Rabbana ma khalaqta hadha batila subhanaka faqina adhaban nar. Rabbana innaka man tudkhil an-nar faqad akhzaytahu. O our Lord, whomever you cast into the fire, you have certainly humiliated him. وَمَا لِلْظَالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارٍ. And there is no one to help the wrongdoers. رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا سَمِيْنَا مُنَادِي يُنَادِي لِلْإِيمَانِ. You know, first a man comes to such conclusions on his own. Now he comes across the call of a prophet.
Tell me, should he take any time to recognize his truth? No.
So, he has already come to such conclusions, though my Lord is Allah, he has created this world for me, and this life is not perhaps a sufficient life, because if this is the rule of Allah, and Allah, here in this life, the culprits are not punished, there should be such a life that culprits are punished. And at that moment, a prophet comes in front of him and reassures him, yes, this is not the whole life. There's going to be another life where the righteous ones will be duly honored and rewarded, and the wrongdoers will be duly punished. What should be his reaction? And see that. Rabbana inna sami'na munadiya yunadi lil iman wa aminu bi rabbikum fa amanna. Our Lord, certainly we have heard a crier calling to believe, that believe in your Lord, so we have come to believe immediately. Rabbana faghfir lana dhunubana. You know, believe, first to believe, but not arrogant. So humble that they don't mention their activities, their performance. They say, oh, please forgive us. Please forgive us. Please forgive us. رَبَّنَا فَغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا وَكَفِّرْ عَنَّا سَيِّئَاتِنَا. Our Lord, please forgive us our sins and blot out from us our misdeeds. وَتَوَفَّنَا مَعَ الْأَبْرَارِ. And also put us to death with the righteous ones. We are not, but please put us to death with the righteous ones. رَبَّنَا وَآتِنَا مَا وَعَدْتَنَا عَلَى رُسُلِكَ. O our Lord, bless us with what you have promised through your messengers to give us. وَلَا تُخْزِنَا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And don't humiliate us on the day of judgment. إِنَّكَ لَا تُخْلِفُ الْمِيعَادَ. We are betraying promises, you don't. إِنَّكَ لَا تُخْلِفُ الْمِيعَادَ. Indeed, you will not go against your promise. Now, they didn't mention their performance. Allah Almighty declares that their prayer has been honored. Their request has been accepted. But while declaring their acceptance, Allah Almighty mentions their performance. فَاسْتَجَابَ لَهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ أَنِّي لَا أُضِيعُ عَمَلَ عَامِلٍ مِّنْكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنثَى. So their Lord accepted their prayer, saying, certainly I don't let an act of any one of you go waste. مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنثَى. May he be a man, or she may be a woman. بَعْضُكُمْ مِنْ بَعْضٍ. You are from one another. فَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا وَأُخْرِجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ. What to talk of those who left for Allah and were out from their homes. وَأُوذُوا فِي سَبِيلِي وَقَاتَلُوا وَقُتِلُوا. And they were persecuted in my cause, and they fought and were even killed. لَوْ كَفْرَنَا عَنْ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ. I shall definitely blot out from them their misdeeds. وَلَأُدْخِلَنَّهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ. And I'll certainly admit them to the gardens beneath which the rivers flow. ثَوَابًا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. As a reward very much from Allah. وَاللَّهُ عِنْدَهُ حُسْنُ الثَّوَابِ. And it's only Allah whom therewith is the best reward. May Allah include us all into them. Subhanallah, we are in the Quran al-Azim and Farni, wa iyyakum bil ayati wa bil